Colonel, does it bother you that we're not calling it a war?
Newsflash for John Kerry, ISIS is at war with us. And of course, the rest of the West and Christianity in general, and of course, anybody who opposes him. So him not saying so is one of the reasons why the support that ought to be there isn't there. I got an idea for him, because this is going to be a, quote, new counterterrorism operation. It needs a name, and I have one for it. Pick one of these two: Operation Enduring Confusion or Operation Many Moving Parts. I mean, it's kind of where we're headed right now.
Yeah, be careful or it'll just get named on its own. President Obama, though, is still saying that ISIL is not Islamic and that that ISIS is not a state. Yeah. Take a listen to this.
ISIL is not Islamic. No religion condones the killing of innocents, and the vast majority of ISIL's victims have been Muslim. And ISIL is certainly not a state.
So you would think that their argument may be that if you say you're at war with them, that's somehow legitimizing them. Do you buy that argument at all?
Not at all. I mean, the fact is, this is a war. It has long been a war. I think it was wrong way back when President Bush said Islam is a religion of peace. It's continued through this administration overtly. And all they do is brag about the fact that bin Laden's dead. Well, bin Laden is dead. But radical Islam is alive and growing, and ISIS is just the biggest, most vicious, well-funded part of it.
Colonel, you've seen a lot of coalitions come together or not come together. I think President Bush had 32 and 26,000 troops and some money. Bush, 41, had the whole war paid for by others. Now Britain has the audacity not to even provide jets. Germany is out. Turkey says, don't even ask me. I mean, how is this acceptable, and where do we go from here?
Well, it's a hard question to answer, and I'm not sure they know in this administration. Look, the way they're talking is Obama has more faith in air power than Billy Mitchell. And we're not going to get a lot of help from our, quote, allies in this broad coalition. I'm grateful that Albania has signed on with us. But when you've already eliminated Great Britain, our closest ally, the NATO force called Turkey, you've got a very serious challenge, because air power alone can decapitate leaders. It can disrupt near-term plans and degrade short-term capability. But it won't destroy ISIS or, quite frankly, any other enemy. That's going to take somebody's troops on the ground. And I seriously doubt, Brian, that you're going to be able to vet, arm, train, and field the so-called moderate operation, the original Syrian Free Army that could have and should have been helped 3 years ago, and do that in a matter of weeks or months. It will take years.
Yeah, well, American boots on the ground, that's been called some sort of red line, but we know the history of red lines here. Colonel North, thank you so much.